Alleluia, Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia. Good morning, everybody, and welcome to worship at Good Shepherd Anglican Church on Treaty 6 territory in Edmonton, Alberta, on Easter Day, the day of our Lord's resurrection. Whether you are with us here in person or you're joining us over Zoom, we're thrilled to be celebrating with you today. If you are worshiping from home, Michelle is available to help you throughout the service. You can just type into the chat if there's anything you need. For those in person, I invite you to silence your cell phones or any other device that may intrude upon the solemnity of the service. Please take a moment now in silence to draw your heart into a time of worship, which will begin in just a moment at the sound of a bell. Hallelujah! Christ our Passover has been sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast.
Oh, come, let us worship. Hallelujah!
Please join in singing our opening hymn, Jesus Christ is Risen Today. Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
May his grace and peace be with you.
May he fill our hearts with joy.
There is one body and one spirit.
There is one hope in God's call to us.
One Lord, one faith, one baptism.
One God and Father of all.
Let us pray. Lord of life and power, through the mighty resurrection of your Son, you have overcome the old order of sin and death and have made all things new in him. May we, being dead to sin and alive to you in Jesus Christ, reign with him in glory, who with you and the Holy Spirit is alive, one God, now and forever. Please be seated for readings from God's holy word.
Thank you.
Please join me in praying a portion of Psalm 118. We'll chant it together. Your signal to change to a new pitch is the word is underlined on the screen in front of you. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever. Let Israel now proclaim, his mercy endures forever. The Lord is my strength and my song, and he has become my salvation.
Right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, is revealed, then you also will be revealed with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise in body or spirit and join in singing the hymn which announces the gospel, Up from the Grave He Arose.
Jesus.
from the grave he rose, with the mighty triumph o'er his foes. He arose a victor from the dark domain, and he lives forever in the saints to reign.
To my God and your God. Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord." And she told them that he had said these things to her. This is the gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. May I speak in the name of our risen Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Mary met Jesus in a garden. Early in the morning, while it was still dark, this faithful woman who loved her Lord went to be among the plants and the animals and all her relations who had kept vigil at the tomb that silent Saturday. It is significant that the new creation begins in a garden because the first creation began there too. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was lush and vibrant, but it was not wilderness. We are told in the scriptures it was a garden, a tender, cultivated place, designed by God for humankind to dwell in. God reveals God's self in a garden. Because gardens show us that love is stronger than death. Death is ever present when gardening, I should know. I am a very lazy, indifferent gardener. My poor, neglected plants often face death. And the only way to prevent it is through faithful, patient, tender care that persists even when progress is imperceptible. The seed is in the ground. It may have sprouted beneath the soil, but we can't see it yet. In order to survive, it needs a gardener who loves it enough to care for it before it is beautiful, to water and weed and wait until spring. But when such a gardener is present, someone not like me, but someone who is willing, early in the morning, while it is still dark, to care for creation with her own hands, that gardener's love is stronger than the death lurking in the shadows, waiting to take her favorite blooms. God is just such a gardener, faithful, patient, persistent even when progress is imperceivable. And in the resurrection of Jesus reveals that that is the kind of love that is stronger than death. That through his faithful, tender, personal, hands-on care, his hands are in the dirt, God is willing to work the power of his love over death. A love that is tender and gentle, but not fragile. A love that has the strength of the faithful persistence of a gardener, whose care is new every morning and brings life to the fruit of the earth. This love has the power through which Christ's death has destroyed death. He has swallowed up death in victory and has laid out a banquet of rich, well-cultivated food to nourish all his creation, all those for whom he cares. Death no longer has dominion over him, and death no longer has dominion over any of us. For we have come to the garden. Make no mistake, this garden is not synonymous with heaven. It is not limited to the paradise to which we go after we die. God came to earth in the person of Jesus of Nazareth. He got his hands dirty in the earth, and his garden is here on earth with us. In the beginning, it was the Garden of Eden in which he cared for Adam and Eve with his own hands, sewing them clothes even after their sin had broken relationship with him. In the resurrection, it was the garden tomb in which he met Mary and called her by name. And now, today, it is the garden that he is inviting us to grow with him, with all those who, like Mary, he has called by name. In just a moment, and I really do mean just a moment, I am wrapping up here, I will invite Elise's family to present her for baptism. But if you too are ready to begin a new life with Jesus, a life where death is not the end of the story, where you will be cared for by a love that is stronger than death, by a God who loves you before you beautifully bloom, Jesus is calling your name now too. You are welcome to stand and present yourself as a candidate for baptism. Because Jesus loves you, just as he did Mary, he is calling you by name. He has been patiently tending the soil in which you are growing for millennia and cannot wait for you to bloom and adorn his garden. Amen. The candidate for holy baptism will now be presented. You want to try it again? Will you be responsible for seeing that this child you present is nurtured in the faith and life of the Christian community? Will you, by your prayers and witness, help this child to grow into the full stature of Christ? Do you renounce Satan and all the spiritual forces of wickedness that rebel against God? Do you renounce the evil powers of this world which corrupt and destroy the creatures of God? Do you renounce all sinful desires that draw you from the love of God? Do you turn to Jesus Christ and accept him as your Savior? Do you put your whole trust in his grace and love? Do you promise to obey him as your Lord? This question is for everybody, and I invite you to rise in body or spirit as you answer. Will you who witness these vows do all in your power to support this person in her life in Christ?
We will.
Let us now pray for Elise and all those who are to receive the sacrament of new birth this Eastertide. Lord, hear our prayer.
Fill them with your holy and life. Open their hearts to your grace and truth.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Fill them with your holy and life-giving spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Teach them to love others in the power of the Spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Send them into the world in witness to your love.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring them to the fullness of your peace and glory.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Grant, O Lord, that all who are baptized into the death of Jesus Christ, your Son, may live in the power of his resurrection and look for him to come again in glory, who lives and reigns now and forever.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
We thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water. Over water, the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through water, you led the children of Israel out of their bondage in Egypt into the land of promise. In water, your son Jesus received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, to lead us through his death and resurrection from the bondage of sin into everlasting life. We thank you, Father, for the water of baptism. In it, we are buried with Christ in his death. By it, we share in his resurrection. Through it, we are reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to your Son, we bring into his fellowship those who come to him in faith, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now sanctify this water by the power of your Holy Spirit, that those who hear are cleansed from sin and born again, may continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ, our Savior. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit, be all honor and glory, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us join with those who are committing themselves to Christ and renew our own baptismal covenant. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord.
He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead.
On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven
and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in God the Holy Spirit?
I believe in God the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread and in the prayers?
I will, with God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord?
I will, with God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will, with God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will, with God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will, with God's help.
Will you strive to safeguard the integrity of God's creation and respect, sustain, and renew the life of the earth?
I will, with God's help.
The congregation may be seated, and I invite Elise and her family to come forward. All right, you ready? Okay. Hey, baby girl, yeah, look at you. You're ready to get baptized. Name this child. Elise, I baptize you in the name of the Father. Woo! And of the Son. Woo! Oh, baby, baby, baby. All right, there we go. Yeah, I know. I did a little too much water there. And of the Holy Spirit. There we go. Okay. Yeah, I know you're okay. Sweet. Elise, I sign you with the cross, and I mark you as Christ's own forever. Yeah. Oh. Go back to mama. There you go. receive the light of Christ and remember it as a sign that you have passed from darkness to light.
Let your light so shine before others that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven.
Heavenly Father, we thank you that by water and the Holy Spirit you have bestowed upon this your servant the forgiveness of sin and have raised her to the new life of grace. Sustain her, O Lord, in your Holy Spirit. Give her an inquiring and discerning heart, the courage to will and to persevere, a spirit to know and to love you, and the gift of joy and wonder in all your works. Let us welcome the newly baptized. We receive you into the household of God. Confess the faith of Christ crucified, proclaim his resurrection, and share with us in his eternal priesthood. And now let us welcome her with applause. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Please offer one another and the newly baptized the sign of peace. Well, good morning, everybody, and welcome again to Good Shepherd. If you're visiting today, we're so very happy to celebrate Christ's resurrection with you. If you are visiting today, we would love to get to know you, so please do introduce yourself in the chat if you're online, or if you're here in person, then please do introduce yourself to us after the service. Are there any birthdays or anniversaries to be blessed today? Harold? Wow, congratulations. Big day for your family. Samantha, your birthday was on Friday. Okay, happy birthday. Pat, your anniversary was yesterday. All right, wonderful, wonderful. Any other, yes, Faye? Ruby's birthday is on Friday. Okay. Anybody else? Yes, Koo.
My brother.
Your brother's birthday's today. Wonderful. Wonderful. Anybody else? Yes, I see a hand back there. Okay. Your birthday was on Tuesday. Wonderful. Just making sure I don't forget anybody. Yes, Perry. It's Sarah's birthday. All right, after the announcements, we will bless all of those. We're also going to bless any Easter baskets that anybody brought with them to church, so you can get those ready if you want to come forward for that. Happy Easter. We're so glad to be celebrating the resurrection of our Lord with you today. Please join us after the service for a festive coffee hour with cake to celebrate the baptisms of Elise and of Liam, who was baptized at the Easter Vigil last night. The office will be closed tomorrow and Tuesday to allow Michelle and me make up statutory holiday time. We appreciate your patience and we'll get back to you on Wednesday. The Wednesday Eucharist and Bible study are still on, so please do come to those. The life of the parish includes many activities as our 50-day celebration of Easter continues. Next Saturday, April 15th, the ACW will be holding their spring sale. Join us next Sunday for Easter lessons and carols so we could get all our favorite Easter hymns in. There's too many good ones. We can't fit them all in today, so we got to do some next week too. Save the date for Compassion Camp. This camp will be held in August and will be an opportunity for kids age 5 to 14 and leaders in training 14 and up to practice compassion. Take a flyer home from the Narthex to remind yourself to sign up once registration opens. Thank you so much to everyone who contributed to our Holy Week worship. The Altar Guild, the music team, our facilities team, readers, acolytes, thurifers, greeters, offertory collectors, and more. And thank you to everyone who donated our special Easter flowers today. There's an Easter flowers flyer in the narthex, and it lists all the commemorations and recognitions. I commend it to you. For all other announcements, I invite you to sign up for the weekly roundup. This is an email we send out once a week. We're never going to send you any spam, but we will keep you up to date on all other announcements, upcoming fellowship events, grief support, and more. As we come into the time of Holy Communion, I invite all people who have ever been baptized in any Christian denomination to come forward to receive. Please make a plate with your hands to receive the wafer like this. We do have gluten-free wafers available. If that's something you need, can you flip your upper hand over so that it's like this? And that'll signal to me quietly that that's a thing that you need. When the wine comes to you, you are welcome to drink from the cup. We do not allow anyone to dip the wafer into the cup. We actually got a scientific report that this is less hygienic than all of us drinking from the same cup. If you don't want to receive the wine, you're not comfortable with it, that's fine. You are welcome to just touch the base of the chalice like this in order to indicate your reverence as it comes to you. If you'd like to come forward to the altar rail but not receive Holy Communion, you're welcome to cross your arms over your chest like you're making the Wakanda salute from the Black Panther movie, and that will signal to me that you would like a blessing. All right, so now we're going to bless the birthdays and the anniversaries. Let's pray. O God, our times are in your hand. Look with favor, we pray, on your servants as they begin another year. Grant that they may grow in wisdom and grace and teach them to trust in your goodness all the days of their lives through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen. All right, anybody who brought an Easter basket to be blessed, you're welcome to come meet me at the font right now. And anybody who came to our Kids Stations of the Cross on Friday and wants to get the last egg that I promised you on Friday was coming, you can come on up. That's okay. Come on up, come on up. You've got chocolate. Is that for me? Or is that for you that you want me to say a blessing on? Okay, then keep it in your bag, sweetie. Okay. Michelle, do you think you could help me hand these out? Thank you. Aaron, do you think you could open this up and tell me what's inside? Some of them are gold and some of them are silver. It's okay. They all have the same thing inside. Thank you, Nema. Good job. A feather? Why do you think there might be a feather? Because Jesus is risen and he's ascended to the skies, all right? You can ask Miss Michelle if there's any gold ones left. Okay? All right. You guys ready? Let's practice this Ukrainian phrase together. Christos Voskres. Voistinu Voskres is your response. Voistinu. All right, let's say it together. Voistinu Voskres. Christos Voskres. Voistinu Voskres. Christos Voskres. Voistinu Voskres. Blessed are you, Lord our God. You bring forth bread from the earth and make the risen Lord to be for us the bread of life. Grant that we who daily seek the bread which sustains our bodies may also hunger for the food of everlasting life. Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. O Lord our God, in preparation for the celebration of the Paschal feast, we have prepared these eggs from your creation. Grant that they may be to us a sign of the new life and immortality promised to those who follow your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord our God. You have given us the risen Savior to be the shepherd of your people. Lead us by him to springs of living waters, and feed us with the food that endures to eternal life, wherewith you, O Father, and with the Holy Spirit, he lives and reigns, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Christos voskres is mervit, smert smert you topche, a tim trove prova dai jitia. Christos voskres, voistinu voskres. Christos voskres, voistinu voskres. Christos voskres, voistinu voskres. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. Please now join in singing our offertory hymn, Alleluia, Raise the Gospel.
Gospel over the earth. Hallelujah.
Let us pray. God, our strength and salvation, receive all we offer you this day, and grant that we who have confessed your name and received new life in baptism may live in the joy of the resurrection through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Blessed are you, gracious God, creator of heaven and earth. We give you thanks and praise for the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. For he is the true Paschal Lamb who has taken away the sin of the world. By his death he destroyed death, and by his rising to life again he has won for us eternal life. Therefore, joining our voices with the whole company of heaven, we sing our joyful hymn of praise to proclaim the glory of your name. Thanks to you, Lord our God, for the goodness and love you have made known to us in creation. In calling Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him, you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him, you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, a death he freely accepted, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, Father, according to his command, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory. And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we, made acceptable in him, may be sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, reconcile all things in Christ and make them new, and bring us to that city of light where you dwell with all your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
As our Savior Christ has taught us, let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Lord, we died with you on the cross.
Now we are raised to new life.
We were buried in your tomb.
Now we share in your resurrection. Live in us that we may live in you.
The gifts of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. rising now in body or spirit, let us pray. God of life, bring us to the glory of the resurrection promised in this Easter sacrament. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, the risen Lord. Amen. Glory to God,
whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to God from generation to generation, in the church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. Amen.
Hallelujah.
May Almighty God, who has redeemed us and made us his children through the resurrection of his Son, our Lord, bestow upon you the riches of his blessing.
Amen.
May God, who through the water of baptism has raised us from sin into newness of life, make you holy and worthy to be united with Christ forever.
Amen.
May God, who has brought us out of bondage into sin, into true and lasting freedom in our Redeemer, bring you to your eternal inheritance.
Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Please join in singing our closing hymn, See What a Morning.
That's okay.